Welcome to Fonts Learn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use the LiveChart control. LiveChart is simple, flexible, interactive and powerful data visualization for .NET. To play the demo, you need to install the LiveChart control from the Manage Nudget packages in your Visual Studio, then rebuild your project. You will see the live chart control automatically added to the Visual Studio toolbox. The Cartesian chart supports many series. You can combine any of these series in a Cartesian chart, such as line series, vertical line series, column series, row series, etc. Drag the Cartesian chart from the Visual Studio toolbox to your WinForm. The Cartesian chart class allows you to plot any series that uses a Cartesian coordinate system. Every point is a pair of values, such as x, y. In simple terms, y will be the value you passed, and x the index of the value in the array. Next, drag the Datagridview control from the Visual Studio toolbox to your WinForm. Datagridview is used to import data for Cartesian charts. You need to create a revenue class allows you to map the data you enter from the data grid view. You need to add a binding source to the data grid view. The binding source component serves many purposes. First, it simplifies binding controls on a form to data by providing currency management, change notification, and other services between Windows Forms controls and data sources. In addition, the binding source component can act as a strongly typed data source. You need to drag the button control from the Visual Studio toolbox to your WinForm, then add the click event handler to the button that allows you to display your data into the Cartesian chart control. We will initialize a Cartesian chart, then add data to the Cartesian chart. As you can see, we will show revenue each month by year. Thank you. You can use the Series Collection class to set data for Cartesian charts. You need to get the year value from the data source, then take the value of the month by year. You can use the link queue to query data in your data source. Finally, add data to Series Collection.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.